In this video, we're going to talk about using linear equations to approximate nonlinear equations and get good predictions of what will happen in the future in a really complicated nonlinear system. So the buzzwords are the microscope equation and local linearity. So first, a little bit of review. Suppose we have something that is linear, that x is changing as a function of t. Here we're imagining we're driving down the highway. At noon, we're at milepost 100, and we're driving at 60 miles an hour. So at t o'clock, we're going to be at 100 plus 60t miles. Okay, simple straight line. We're moving at a constant rate. And you should be careful with units. If this is in miles, then this has got to be in miles. And 60t has to be in miles. 60 is in miles per hour. T is in hours. The rate of change is 60, not the number 60, but 60 miles per hour. It's output, that is miles, per input, that is hours. So 60 miles per hour was our rate of change. And we saw that that's also the slope of the line that you get if you graph this function. And it's a conversion factor. You can get the change in position as a function of the change in time, or you can get how long it'll take as a function of how far you're going. So far, so good. But what if we have something nonlinear? For example, let's look at the function square root of x. Now, it happens that the square root of 4 is 2. Great. And it also happens that you can figure out the rate of change at this point. We may not have developed the formulas for getting this, but trust me, the slope of the tangent line is a quarter. So the rate of change happens to be a quarter. Can we use that to figure out what the square root of 4.1 is, or the square root of 3.9? Well, the key thing here is, how much does the slope change between 3.9 and 4.1? It doesn't change much. I mean, it's flattening out a little bit. But if you look over a very, very short period, the slope here and the slope here and the slope here are practically the same. And that means that if you take this picture and you just blow it up, you zoom in on this little part of the curve, you get a picture that looks kind of like this. You get the curve, the slope here and the slope here and the slope here are practically the same. In other words, it's practically a straight line. And what's the slope of that straight line? Well, it's the rate of change at 4. In other words, it's slope 1 quarter. So if we can use a line of slope 1 quarter to give us a really good approximation to this curve. So let's see how that works. Here we have a line of slope 1 quarter. And what that means is if I take a nearby point, x, the change here is delta x. And so since the slope is 1 quarter, the change in y is just going to be a quarter of the change in x. Well, the change in y is y minus 2. So this is what we call delta y. And delta y is a quarter of delta x. That's what it means to have a slope of a quarter. So when x is 4.1, that means that delta x is 0.1, so delta y is a quarter of that. That's 0.025. So y must be 2.025. See, here y was 2. We went up by 0.025. So this was the point 4.1, 2.025. Okay. Now, if you pull out a calculator and compute the square root of 4.1, you'll actually get 2.02485. It's not quite 2.025, but it's darn close. And if you want to know what's the square root of 3.9, well, that's going to the left. Here, delta x is minus 0.1, so delta y is minus 0.025. And so the square root of 3.9 is practically 2 minus 0.025. That's 1.975. and you could likewise figure out the square root of any number. You want the square root of any number close to 4, and it's going to be the starting point, that's 2, plus 1 quarter of delta x. Now, you notice that these aren't exact. And the reason is that we're not literally a straight line. The actual curve curves a tiny bit. Because it's curving a tiny bit, and it's curving downwards, the actual value is a little bit lower than the predicted value. And over here, the actual value is a little bit lower than the predicted value. So over here, the actual value is 0.02485, and the predicted value was 2.025. So this 5 versus this 485. It's a tiny bit too high. Later on, we're going to come up with ways to quantify how much we missed by. But for now, just accept that this is darn accurate. It's not exact because it's not literally a straight line, but it's approximately a straight line, and we can use that to understand the future.